Hey guys, welcome back to electronicsinnovation.com. In this video, we are going to talk all about IoT-based smart patient production monitor with ESP8266 and sending critical medical alerts to the hospital management and patient caretakers. This project truly designed for the people whose production levels need to be monitored 24/7 continuously. For example, COVID patients or any other patients who are on the ventilator. This project continuously monitors particular person's blood oxygen levels and then logs them into the UPDOTS platform. And also it will send critical medical alerts to the hospital management and patient caretakers whenever the blood oxygen levels goes below the threshold with the help of UPDOTS event and alerts feature. I'm so excited about this project to share with you. So without wasting much time, let's dive into the episode. Wait. Before jumping into the episode, let me thank my favorite PCB manufacturer, PCBWay.com, for sponsoring this video.
This video is sponsored by PCBWay.com. PCBWay is the one of the best PCB manufacturers in the current industry. PCBWay is offering services like PCB prototyping, assembly stencil, PCB assembly, flexible PCBs, and advanced PCBs. At PCBWay.com, we can get 10 pieces of 2-layer PCBs at just $5 with 24 hours build time. The best part of PCBWay is the instant quote feature. Just enter the PCB size, choose quantity, layers and thickness. That's it. We will get the instant quote. Place the order by clicking on save to cart.
Now, let's move to the most important part of the episode, creating alerts when abnormal blood oxygen levels is noticed. UPDOTS supports integrated events to allow us to send alerts and notifications to those who need to know when they need to know. In our case, the hospital management and the caretaker of the patient should know whenever the blood oxygen levels are go down. So, let's configure it now. Select Events from Data drop-down. Click on the Create Event button. Select the If Triggers tab to organize your event logic. First, we will create a condition to trigger the event and then call the appropriate action to take place. Click on Select Variable. Then select the device Oxygen Monitor. And then select the variable SpO2. I wanted to use SpO2 data for conditional expression, so I have selected SpO2. Establish event logic if the value is less than or equals to 95% for 1 minute. That's it. Event logic for If Triggers tab is completed. Select the Then Action tab to execute the planned event or alert such as email, SMS, Telegram or voice call. Click on Add New Action, then select and configure the which action are to be executed and message for the receiver. Available actions include email, SMS, Telegram, voice call, set variable, Slack or webhooks. First of all, I would like to configure email. Enter the email address. We can add two or more emails by simply separating them with a comma. Then type the alert mail subject and message as you wish. You can also add specific data inputs like variable name, device label, trigger value, trigger timestamp into the event for the immediate info. After configuring the message, create it. Likewise, we can configure and create the rest of the alerts like SMS, Telegram and voice call. All you have to do is providing the target mobile number along with the country code and the alert message. For voice call, you can select the voice of the alert message between John and Alice. Whereas John is a male voice and Alice is a female voice, then the rest of the details are as same as the SMS and Telegram message. So,
All these alerts are configured to trigger when the SpO2 value is less than or equals to 95% for 1 minute. After creating an alert, it is inevitable that the event will be triggered at some point. One great feature of the UBDOT's events engine is the back to normal conditional notification. It will send another alert if the triggered value came back to normal. To activate the back to normal notification, simply follow the below steps. Select the back to normal tab from the events actions tab. Select the trigger this action box to verify the desire to receive a back to normal notification. Add the custom notification text as you see fit. Then save action. Likewise, enable the back to normal notification to the rest of the Telegram message, SMS and email alerts. After configuring all alerts, click on Next. Here, you can give a meaningful name to your event and determine when should the events to be executed and not executed. For our solution, we have to monitor the patient oxygen levels 24/7. So, keep it default and save it. That's it. The event successfully configured to give us an alert whenever the SpO2 value is less than or equals to 95% for 1 minute and whenever the value went back to the normal. Here you can see the details of the created event like type of alerts and some other options like event log, edit event, copy event, enabling or disabling event and deleting the event. These options will help us further management of the event. Now it's time to test this event. So come back to the dashboard. Here the data is being updated seamlessly. To make this SpO2 less than 95%, I'm gonna remove the finger from the top of the sensor. So it will send 0 reading which will satisfy the event condition. Let's wait for 1 minute to get the event alerts. Yes! After 1 minute, we have received a voice call from UBDOT. Let's lift it and listen to the message.
Hey there, patient. John's blood oxygen percent SpO2 was 0.0 at February 16, 2021, 13, 18 and 49 seconds, plus 0530 for 1 minute. Please take necessary actions as soon as possible.
That was amazing. What about SMS? Yeah, we have also received the SMS. You can read the text which is as same as the configured. We also received Telegram message from IoT notification. Maybe this IoT notification is the bot created by UBDOT. Anyway, we have received the Telegram alert. Let's check the mail now. Mail also received from notification UBDOT with the subject and mail body we have configured on the event. So, all 4 alerts were triggered and sent to the configured receiver. For demonstration, I have provided my personal mobile number. For real-time scenarios, we can simply replace my number with hospital management, patient caretakers or patient loved ones who need to know whenever the oxygen levels are go down. We can see the log of the event at the event log option. If there is any problem with the mobile number or email, the alert cannot be delivered. So you never receive an alert. In that case, you can check here. If there is any problem, a detailed description of the problem can be found here. It will help us in debugging. So, all these alerts are triggered when SpO2 value is less than or equals to 95% for 1 minute. Now it's time to test the back to normal alert feature. To make this SpO2 greater than 95%, I'm gonna place my finger on top of the sensor. So it will send the exact readings of my body, which will satisfy the event condition to trigger back to normal alert. Yes, after 1 minute, we have received a voice call from QBDOTS again. Let's lift it and listen to the back to normal message.
We are happy to let you know that John's blood oxygen name, SpO2, ID 602501097 3EFC337-6CC6B03, properties, last underscore value, 96.0, timestamp, 161346177084 5, last underscore value underscore context, SpO2 back to normal. Thank you for the support.
Zing zing, amazing. I fall in love with this feature. Likewise, we have received SMS alert and Telegram message alert from IoT notification. Also, we have received the mail from notification UBDOTS with the subject and mail body we have configured on back to normal event. That's all about developing an IoT based smart patient blood oxygen meter with ESP8266 and sending critical medical alerts to the hospital management and caretakers and patient loved ones. I hope you have learned something new from this episode. Stay tuned to Electronics Innovation for more interesting projects. See you on the next interesting project. Bye-bye.